Hey, good morning, everyone. Robb here from Southwest Florida Television. Happy Thursday. A pretty nice morning here in Southwest Florida. I'm up at Wiggins Pass, at the very north end of Del Nor Wiggins Pass State Park. Catching some of the colors of sunrise here this morning. Beautiful, beautiful colors. Absolutely gorgeous. Looking to the east here. I haven't been up here for sunrise for quite a while. Absolutely gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous here. I gotta take a photo, hang on. Beautiful. We're up at Wiggins Pass up in North Naples, Florida. We're enjoying this beautiful sunrise. Please don't forget all of the folks along our Atlanta coastline that are in the path of Hurricane Florence. Please keep them in your prayers as Florence approaches. I know we've got some good friends here on Facebook that are in her path. Please say a prayer for all those people and all of the first responders. Don't forget about all of the people that have already left and are headed that way to help. A beautiful blue heron over here, just on the edge of the screen. I'm gonna snap off a quick photo. Hang tight. Gorgeous. This is where our friend Roy comes up and says his morning prayers, right up here at Wiggins Pass, about this time. Just gorgeous out here. The tide is still moving out here. Low tide's about 10:30. Nice little breeze. Let's see if we see the sun come up over the trees here. There's a lot of clouds out there on the horizon. It's actually up right now. 7:10 was sunrise. Thank you. there's a great blue heron over there. Got a little color up here in the sky, a little bit of pink. Just a little pink above me here. It's looking down to the south. That's looking up the Cocoahatchee River to the east. Absolutely gorgeous. Yeah, no fishermen out here this morning. Pretty quiet. Right where that bright spot is where the sun's gonna be rising. How quickly the colors change. We had some pinks and oranges and reds. Now we're getting into the yellows and golds. Current is really moving fast. The tide is on its way out. The current's coming this way. Well, we're off to the start of another wonderful day. Here in Southwest Florida. Not quite the same to our friends up in the Carolinas. And again, please keep everybody in the path of Hurricane Florence in your prayers. We've got some people watching that live up there. a lot of fish jumping out there in the pass. Beautiful, beautiful great blue heron here in front of me. Look at those pastels, soft pastel colors. Gorgeous. Well, here comes our sun, just peeking up over the trees. I know Roy misses being out here so much. Good morning, Naples. Beautiful. I gotta take a picture for Roy. All right, well, we got to watch the sunrise this morning. That was nice. I think I'm gonna walk down the beach and see if we find any shells. Hopefully I'll be able to get around the trees here. These beautiful colors. Very, very soft pastel colors this morning. As we look north here, see if I can zoom in. Let's see, all the way up to Fort Myers Beach. Birds. Look at all those birds. It's a flock of pelicans. Here they come. Oh, they're all going to hang out over at Barefoot Beach. Beautiful. Gorgeous out here. All the birds waking up. water looks nice up here, even though the tide's on its way out. Well, let's walk down the beach and see if we find anything interesting. There's a nice line of shells up here at the high tide line, all along the beach. I'm kind of torn. Where do I want to walk, up here or down by the water? I think I'm going to go down by the water. A jogger just scared the bird away. Darn it. I've seen a lot of fish out here in the water this morning. What a beautiful sunrise we had. I think I got a couple nice pictures. Isn't that beautiful, that blue sky? It's looking north. North towards Barefoot Beach. So soft, the colors are so soft up there this morning. There goes some pelicans. What a glorious morning. As our friend Roy would say, what a glorious morning. Boy, the water is absolutely gorgeous out here this morning. I don't know what the water temperature is. If you're curious, easy enough to find out with a simple Google. The water is beautiful though. Nice and clear. Beautiful color. Nice and flat out there. Oh, wow. This heron up here has been walking the beach, a great blue heron, has a loose feather. I would love to get a blue heron feather. It's sticking out on the right side. It's ready to fall off. somebody's gonna get themselves a nice little treasure if they know what they're looking for. Beautiful birds. That bird's standing about 3 foot tall. When it stretches its neck, it's about almost 4 foot tall when it stretches its head up. Ah, darn it. When I took off, I thought maybe that feather was gonna fall off. That would be quite a souvenir. Anything out here running around in the water? Still a little dark. Hard to see out here. See our birds down there in area 4. Not seeing a lot of shells. There's one of our shell trees here. All the shells that people hang in memory of their loved ones. Here's a couple that I hung last week. Excuse me. There's two shells that I hung last week. Still here, thankfully. That shell right here, that was for Roy. And that shell was for all of our Facebook friends right there. You know, while we're watching, looking at these shells right here, why doesn't everybody just take a minute? Let's say a quick prayer for all the people in the path of that Hurricane Florence and for our friend Roy. Let's just take a moment of silence here. Amen. It is so calm out there in the Gulf this morning. It's been like that a lot lately. Hey, it looks like I've got some beach to walk on down here this morning. Normally there's no beach, but look how much erosion. Looks like we've had more erosion up here in Area 5. Looks like it's getting ready to take out some more of our trees here, unfortunately. Crazy. Crazy, crazy. Just me and the birds this morning. This beautiful blue heron. Oh goodness. I believe there's three great blue herons lined up here in front of me. What a sight. What a sight. Three of them lined up here in front of me. Don't see that very often. I'm gonna try to keep back and get a picture of them. Bear with me. I'm being selfish, sorry. I was hogging this to myself. Three blue herons here in front of me. Three great blue herons. What a sight. Off they go. What a beautiful sight. Three great blue herons sitting on the beach here up in Area 5. I really haven't seen any shells yet that I wanted to pick up and add to my collection. We're still a couple hours away from low tide, at least, maybe 2.5 hours away from low tide. Take a walk out on that little bird island over here, our sandbar. Good morning. This is Area 4. Most of you know this is where I would meet up with our friend Roy and have our conversations on this beach right here, on this section of beach. What a gorgeous morning. Absolutely beautiful out here. I almost have the place to myself. Beautiful sunrise this morning. You'll have to catch that later. Watch the replay. Beautiful sunrise. The water is just beautiful out here this morning. Nice and clean. So tranquil. Still have the beautiful colors of sunrise out there in the Gulf. All I'm seeing are there so far are a lot of our conch shells. Seeing lots of little fighting conchs on the beach. Lots of fighting conchs, Florida fighting conchs. All empty. Beautiful, look at those little waves. Boy, this tide is really low this morning. Very, very low. It's going to be a good morning to get out in the water and do some shelling. Cannot believe how low the tide is here, and it's getting lower. The tide is still on its way out. Fun watching the little birds scurry around. There's a lot of little sandpipers out here this morning. Lots of little fish swimming around out here in the water. Haven't seen any dolphins coming by yet. Isn't that beautiful? Look at that sky. Early morning light. The sun's behind some pretty heavy clouds out there to the east. Beautiful though here, the water is nice and clear. You can see there's a conch shell right down there in the water. If you look close, you can see the conch shell. Beautiful looking down to the south. Where I'm walking is normally underwater. Boy, I am surprised here. No shells have really gotten my attention yet. Normally I'd be up here shelling. That tide is really low this morning. Look at this pile of shells here, just all piled up here. Just a nice ridge, waiting for somebody to start digging into them. Wow. I am scanning the beach here as I walk along. Hoping to find something to pick up, and I am not having any luck here. I am just striking out this morning. It's still kind of dark out here. The sun is tucked in behind some clouds. Makes it a little hard to spot the shells on the beach. It's nicer when you got some nice bright sunlight. everything just kind of gets mixed together when it's not bright out. It's just amazing how low the tide is right now, and it's still got another few hours to go till low tide. For those of you just tuning in, we had a gorgeous, gorgeous sunrise this morning. You'll be able to see that in the replay of this video at the conclusion of the live feed. Darn it. Here's our nest, sea turtle nest number 60. Those blasted raccoons have made it under the wire mesh. You're gonna have to put that down a little deeper. Looks like they got into some of the eggs. I see some broken eggshells here. Hopefully they didn't get all the eggs. But these darn raccoons destroyed a lot of nests this season. The reason for that was, believe it or not, because of the red tide. You're like, what does a red tide have to do with raccoons and turtle nests? Well, what happens is, nobody came out to the beach for about a month. The beach was absolutely deserted for a month. So the raccoons were starving because people weren't leaving their trash from their picnics behind. Those scraps of food that the raccoons are so used to pulling out of the trash cans. So the raccoons were getting desperate and they resorted to digging into our turtle nests. Sad, sad, sad. So we lost quite a few sea turtle nests because of the red tide. But hopefully they didn't get all of the eggs out of the nests. Hopefully some of the eggs survived. We're getting down to near the end of nesting, of actually hatching season. We've got maybe a handful of nests still left on the beach. Hopefully they'll hatch. But we did have a record number of nests here this season. Well, there's definitely shells out here at the beach. Let me say that. If anybody wants to come out and do some shelling, there are plenty of shells out here. I'm just having a hard time seeing them right now because they're in the shadows. I'm sure as soon as that sun comes up, we're gonna find something there. Dolphins are out here. There was a dolphin just came up over here. I think they're heading north. Let's see if they pop up again. It just popped up out there. I don't see him now. Look how calm it is out there, though. Just incredible. It's like glass out there. I don't see him now. they just kind of stuck their fin up. I don't know where they went. I know they're out there, that's for sure. There's some fish jumping out here in front of me. Could a dolphin be chasing them? I don't know. There's a fisherman gonna try to get his line out there. They might be snook out there. They're right out here rolling around. Right out in where that reflection is, right about where my finger is. Wow, big one just jumped up out there. See, you can see the water stirring out there. Right about in the center of the screen is where the fish are jumping. Of course, now they stop. There's one, a little ripple. Doing it, figures. See if we get a little more action out there. Darn it. There's a little jumper. They're right in that reflection, right around that reflection. There they go, see them? Something's chasing them. Finally, now you have to believe me. Ugh. This guy fishing, he had one on his line, he got away. He had a bite over here. He had something on his line, but it got off. Fish are jumping right out in here. That's gorgeous. Close. Good, how are you doing? It's gorgeous out here. Beautiful Thursday morning. still a couple hours away from low tide. Look how low the tide is already, just amazing. Extremely low here right now. Beautiful sunrise this morning. Absolutely gorgeous. We'll definitely want to check out the replay of the video here. Here's one of our little snowy egrets looking for some breakfast. The water's gorgeous here, absolutely gorgeous. Going to go down to better hunting grounds. Something just jumped right out here. He's just gonna make his way down the beach there, following the fish. Just hoping to see him catch something here. I gotta turn around, start heading back up to where we started. We started up at Wiggins Pass this morning for a change, something different. Absolutely beautiful this morning. It's been very quiet here. Thinking about everybody over on our eastern coastline here and the Carolinas and everybody in that path of Hurricane Florence. Please be praying for them. Hurricanes are devastating. We've had our share of them here in Florida. We're still recovering here in Southwest Florida from Hurricane Irma. That was a year ago on this date, September 13th. So please, please keep all those folks in your prayers. Hopefully the predictions that the forecasters are making aren't going to come to reality. 24 inches, but potential rainfall, wow. Let's hope something happens in Florence. Starts weakening and drying out. Seems like it's going to be quite a rain event, no matter what. They've had enough rain up there already. I haven't walked out this far here in quite a while. Or it's just above my ankles out here. Beautiful with the reflections here. Early morning light. Seagull bobbing out here in the water in front of me. Tons of little fish out here in the water. Tons of them. Still just a little dark out here. The sun is not coming out from behind the clouds this morning. Kind of hard to see in the water. But it's beautiful, nice and clear. Beautiful sky. I don't know if you can see these little fish swimming by me. Yeah, they're going around me now. They were just coming right by me. Tons of them. They're all over here now. There went some. They just come back and forth, swim back and forth. See if some more come by. Something chasing after him. Just up here. There goes some. I'm sure you can see him swimming by there. See him? Amazing. The water is just loaded with them. Loaded with these little fingerlings. Birds are having quite the picnic, their breakfast buffet. Come on, dolphins. I'd love to see some dolphins come swimming by now. I saw one pop up earlier and lost it. I don't know where he went. A little tricolor heron up here. haven't seen those guys. This is the first I've seen them since the red tide out here. I don't want to startle it. I'd like to get you a little closer. It's a little tricolored heron out there. That's the first one of those I've seen since we had our red tide bout. Got something to eat there. Got himself a fish. Herself, itself. Good timing. Little tricolored heron. We saw some beautiful great blue herons this morning. I actually saw three of them lined up on the beach this morning. Absolutely, absolutely an amazing sight to see three great blues here at the beach. Again, we're looking at a little tricolored heron. Walking away from me here. I'm trying to keep up with it. See if it gets another fish here. Gonna catch something or not? There's a ton of fish out here. Getting ready. Well, that bird has more patience than me. Come on, get something. There you go. Did he get one? Nope. Shame on you. A failure. Oh well. There's plenty more fish for you out there. Probably camera shy. I've not picked up any shells yet this morning. Nothing has really grabbed me. Very unusual. being low tide like this, I was expecting to find a lot of shells out here, but no. I mean, there are shells, but just a lot of broken shells, a lot of clam shells. Very quiet all around this morning at the beach and on Facebook here. Nothing but broken shells, darn it. I see a broken tulip shell down here. Piece of a tulip. That's all I've been seeing, though, this morning is broken shells in the water. That's what's left of a banded tulip shell. Hey, some sunlight. Beautiful. A little bit of sunlight out here. That's the first sunlight that has broken through the clouds. I love it. Now you can see how beautiful that water is. Absolutely gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous. Hopefully that sun's gonna stay out for a minute. I just want to get a picture up the beach here. Bear with me. All right. Now we got some sunlight out here. It's gonna be ducking behind the clouds again, but now we can get a nice look at the water real quick. Beautiful, nice and clear. Actually got a shadow out there. Hey, good morning, everybody. Not gonna be out for long though. The clouds are rolling through again. Gonna be rolling through. There's a look down to the south. Beautiful. It's starting to go behind the clouds again. Doesn't take much to excite me. A little bit of sun on the beach. It's gorgeous. Now we're back in the shade again. It was nice while it lasted. Listen to the birds. an old whelk shell, an old broken lightning whelk. Two broken shells this morning, a broken lightning whelk, and then we saw a broken tulip shell earlier. A little olive shell down here. Nice colors on the olive shell. Every time I pick an olive shell up, it's always got other shells stuck inside it. This one's missing the tip. The olive shell. Walk by our terns again out here on the sandbar. Beautiful sounds. Extreme low tide here, still getting lower. Roy's trees over there. this is usually all underwater out here. Right over here is that tricolored heron. If I can zoom in here. There's a tricolored heron and a little snowy egret. A little snowy on the left. That's that same tricolored heron we saw earlier, I believe. To see here in the shadows. I got to get skedaddling here. We started up at the north end this morning for a change. We got out there and got to watch the sunrise. That was fun. A piece of a whelk shell buried in the sand out here. Little piece of a lightning whelk. It's kind of neat. You can see inside of the lightning whelk. Actually, this is a pear whelk. This is a pear whelk. It has the opening on the opposite side of a lightning whelk. The pear whelk. It's a little smoother than a lightning whelk. There's a good look at the inside of a pear whelk. Very cool. There's anything else out here in the water as I'm walking back up north here. Normally where I'm walking is usually underwater, right? All out in this area here. But we are not even at low tide yet. We're having a really low tide out here this morning. Pretty darn beautiful out here. Pretty darn beautiful. There's a beautiful conch shell down here. Just the top of it was sticking up out of the sand. Look at the pattern. Look at that conch shell. Look at the stripes on that conch shell. That is beautiful. That is a beautiful Florida fighting conch right there. Absolutely gorgeous. Wow. Look at that. The spectacular shell right there. Boy, the water is absolutely gorgeous. Nice and clear. Just don't have a lot of sun out this morning. So our colors aren't as vibrant. But it is beautiful, nonetheless. There's a big piece of worm rock. Neat piece of worm rock in the water. I just find that so fascinating. All these worm tubes. So neat. Plunk. Back to the water it goes. Seen a lot of fighting conchs out here. There's two right down here in the water if you look close. There's one right here, one right there. Two Florida fighting conchs. We've actually got a little beach up here in Area 5. Look at that. Usually this is all underwater up here. See some of the old tree stumps and the roots that are out here. These are usually submerged. Little fish love swimming around these things and hiding in them. Those all used to be buried. These were under probably 4 foot of sand at one time a year ago. Now the beach is all washed away here. Now all these stumps are sticking up again. Very, very calm out there in the Gulf today. Look how flat that is. Just some little tiny waves rippling on the shore here. We had a beautiful sunrise. I was out here for sunrise this morning, so be sure to watch the replay of the video. Check out the sunrise. Gorgeous. Again, I can't say it enough. Please keep everyone in the path of Hurricane Florence in your prayers and your thoughts and prayers, including all of the first responders that are going to risk their lives during this storm. They're going to put their lives on the line, saving people that should have evacuated, and it happens every hurricane. Please keep everyone in your prayers. Please keep our friend Roy in your prayers. Keep those cards coming for Roy. He gets a kick out of those cards. He loves all those cards, everybody. You don't know how happy he is when he gets those cards. The joy that gives him. Visitors and cards, that's the best therapy he can get right now. And he is doing better. I'll be stopping by and visiting him later today. Yesterday, he sure looked happy on his little exercycle there. If you watched that video, he was in a really good mood. I think he forgot he was exercising when he was talking to me. It's probably everyone watching now, right at this moment, knows that I don't get paid to come out here, and every once in a while somebody will send me a little something. I really appreciate it. A little contribution now and then goes a long way. It helps pay the phone bill, and if anybody wants to help out, you can find my PayPal account information in the description of this post at the conclusion of this live feed. Those of you that have sent something, thank you so much. I really appreciate it. Looks like we are losing a little more beach up here at the north end of the park, unfortunately. Up in Area 5. Beautiful shell trees, prayer trees. I'm going to give you one more look around. We're looking to the north here. Going to slowly pan out into the Gulf and then down to the south. But be sure to tell your friends about Southwest Florida Television. Please take the time to check out all of my photos and videos. When you find something you like, hit the like and share button both. Be sure to follow and like Southwest Florida Television on Facebook. Get the follow and like. It was a very quiet morning this morning. Not a lot of people watching. I'm sure a lot of people are getting prepared for Florence. You know, keeping their eyes glued to the weather channel. I don't blame you. That's what I would be doing if I was in that hurricane's path. We'll be thinking about you. We'll be praying for you. Well, thanks for tuning in this morning. Have a wonderful Thursday. And God bless.